My first impression was her energy and her passion for the community. You know, I just said, this is the woman I want for our campus.
She's been doing work with the NHPI, which is a Native Hawaiian and Pacific Islander community, for nearly 2 decades now. And she's been doing wonderful research from breast and cervical cancer to colorectal, a number of different things in helping bring light to this somewhat invisible community.
For instance, you know, one project that I just completed is to design and test an intervention to improve pap testing among Pacific Islanders. For many years, I've been working in partnership with community agencies, and we designed and developed and then tested an intervention that involved educating women, but also their partners, their male partners, because we know that in collectivistic communities, it's not really an individual's decision about health, right? But that individual, who's oftentimes the caregiver for the family, in order to prioritize her health, we really need to pull in other members of the family and educate them about how they can support and promote that.
Not only has she brought in millions of dollars to the campus, but also to provide opportunities for our faculty and the community to work together.
I'm not sure exactly what drives her, but I can see that through the work that she's doing and the way that she cares about the people that her work impacts.
I think the drive to help other communities really comes from my own personal and family experience. You know, my parents were immigrants. I grew up learning about all the discrimination and prejudice that they faced. And my parents are highly educated. We lived in a safe suburban environment, and yet they were still singled out for being different and treated differently and had different opportunities because of that. So they instilled in me a sense of social responsibility.
What I've learned from Dr. Tangesiri is she balances her life, and to be able to see that you can do research, you can do teaching, you can serve the community, you can be on boards and advisory committees, but she's always there for her family.
I will remember her as the most impactful person I've ever met on this campus. The fact that she can do things, that inspires me to also do things in my own regard as well.
As a diversity supplement, she found a position for me to work in her lab, to come back and get this Master's of Public Health degree and be able to launch this new career in this new direction where I can help my own community now, because I was not doing that before. So this has been a huge, huge gift that she's given me.
The impact that she's made on her students will be one of her best legacies, because they'll be taking it out into the community and affecting so many people, and the people they affect more. So that's one. A second one is the impact that she has made on young faculty and mentoring them to be successful.
One of the pleasures in my professional life is that I've never had anyone here at Cal State Fullerton say no to a research idea. Because at the end of the day, when I'm able to take this back and share with students or share with administrators, people recognize that research happens in many forms, and I'm very, very grateful for that.